Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. So in the last part we cleared out this tower here, which I'm jumping around in front of. We killed the boss for level 6. And as you know, we already cleared the small towers earlier, so there's really nothing left to do here. I finished off all the monsters that are roaming around outside that we can find. There's a couple more which I will get to now, because those are the ones that are protecting the entrance to level 7. Now the entrance to level 7 is a little bit tricky again, because there's no direct path to get to it, except if you use maybe something like winged boots or a mantle or something like that. But if we're going to waste items getting into level 7, then we might as well just use a Madoc and go straight for the permanent opening here. Because if we use a mantle, of course, we will have to use another mantle if ever we want to go back through. So, we equip our Madoc, we make a hole in the wall right here. And this leads us to the entrance to level 7, which you can see over here. Now, the entrance to level 7 at this stage is still closed, because, well, I don't have enough levels yet. But before we go ahead and level up and start wasting a lot more food and other stuff, I will clear out the remaining monsters from this area. There's one more Necrophidius and one more Raiden here to kill. They give us a fair bit of gold and food and some nice items as well. So yeah, it's going to be worth killing them. Another reason why I want to kill these guys is because I want to build up my fighter experience a little bit. As I said in the previous part, we've been neglecting that somewhat because the monsters have been getting quite strong up here. But it's going to be important for the coming few levels that we get as much fighter experience as possible, because we don't just want to level our wizard from here on. And yeah, the following levels, monsters are going to be a lot tougher than they have been so far, so it's going to be much harder to beat them in melee combat like I'm doing now. Another reason is that we've built up our armor experience pretty well. Our total defense is now over 10,000, so these guys are no longer doing, like, I don't know, 20, 30,000 damage a hit, but more like maybe 3 or 4. So that means we can afford to use our melee weapon on these guys. Especially because they also drop so much gold that it's going to be easy for us to heal up after this. So yeah, just... And these guys are worth like 300 experience each. So, yeah, our experience is going to be pretty good from killing these guys. You have to be a little bit careful, because as you see, all those little 2,000, 3,000 hits do add up. And already I'm down to 55,000 hit points from, I think it was 90 when I started or so. So do be careful a little bit, but broadly speaking, this is relatively safe. And again, this will also add to our armor experience again, so that's also going to be worth it. We will be using the full plate for a little while, I think. I don't think we'll be getting any better armor until level 8 or so. So it's worth building up experience with it. Oops, there we go. Now neither of these guys drop poison, so you can just loot whatever they drop. You don't have to be careful. In fact, they drop very useful items like pendants and keys. Now, after I beat these guys, I'm going to go back down a couple of levels. I probably do either 2 or 3 levels from my new experience. I'm pretty sure at least 2 wizard levels and maybe 1 or 2 fighter levels, I'm not quite sure. But I will go back to the king for that, because I want to... Well, there's a couple of things I want to do. I want to improve our agility a little bit. And more than I would from just a single fighter level, the 5 extra agility we'd get there. Let's have a quick look at the stats. See, our strength is more than enough right now. Our intelligence is also... could be a little bit better, but it's plenty for the moment. Our wisdom is solid. I'm getting maybe 100,000 hit points healed from our red potion now, so I don't think we need too much more wisdom for the moment. Charisma obviously is going to be plenty for the from now on. What I really want is to increase my agility and maybe my magic resistance somewhat. Agility to stay competitive in hand-to-hand combat. Magic resistance obviously to protect ourselves from the stronger magic attacks that we are going to be facing in the coming few levels. Magic resistance a little bit less important, I think, because there aren't so many monsters that use strong magic attacks. But at the same time, there are a couple, so you do want to invest in that a little bit at least. I'm hoping this last raiden will make its way up. Here we go. And that's all the remaining monsters for this level. Now let me show you how to get back to the earlier levels from here, because I was talking about this earlier on. It's a little bit tricky. The same way that the portal back to level 7 is here behind this area that you needed to Madoc into, the same is true here for the portal back to level 5. But there's actually a little bit more to it than that. And that is that the portal to level 5 is also protected on the other side. As you can see, if we go down here, we can't go back, so make sure if you go down this ladder that you actually want to go back down to the earlier levels. So from here on in, I couldn't go back up. The only way I'd go could go is down here and then go all the way back around and find the hole we just broke open in the wall again. Of course, so like I said, let's go back to level 5 first. And here as well, the entrance is guarded by on all sides by these blue bricks. Now we could Madoc these open as well if we came in from the top, but there's like 6 or 7 or 8 of them, so we'd waste a whole lot of Madocs on that. We could also use a mantle to go through them. If you have reasonably high wisdom, you could probably get through them with one mantle, but then if you'd ever want to go through there again, you'd have to use another mantle, which of course is very expensive. Let me get rid of these mudmen here. Not quite sure. Pretty sure these guys are relatively weak, but our hit points are very low at the moment, so I'm going to be a little bit careful. So anyway, yeah, there's a couple of different ways you could do this. Oh, sadly, we can't make this mudman respawn. So, oh well. There's actually another trick we could do. We can equip a fire crystal in this case. And as you, if you remember from the earlier videos, fire crystals make you go down a level. So instead of wasting our precious items on getting through all this stuff, instead we will just use a fire crystal to go straight back to level 4. 4, yeah. And that way we don't have to use a Madoc, which is very expensive, or... what was I saying? A mantle, which is also, yeah, pretty useful and something you don't want to waste for no good reason. Fire gems aren't the cheapest, but you don't use them for that many other purposes than what we were just talking about. I think we can take hornets now pretty easily, yeah. If you remember, these guys used to be very powerful, but now we can just take them out. I'm not sure why I hadn't killed this guy yet, but oh well. Okay, so from here on we can just use the regular route back to the earlier levels. And head all the way back to the king. Probably, yeah. I'm not going to bore you with showing you the entire path. I will just pause the recording here and see you when I'm back in level 1. Welcome back, guys. We're all the way back in the starting area now. In the meantime, I've also, since we were passing the shops anyway, decided to pick up a bit more food and top up our keys again. We're back at almost 130. I wasted one by accident. Unfortunately, I think I went a little bit overboard and spent too much of our gold, which means we won't be able to afford our full heal when we get back, but that's okay. I think at this stage maybe red potions are actually a little bit more cost effective anyway. In fact, you know what? Let's just see how much they are and maybe use the rest of our gold to stock up on them. It's always good to do that before you level up, because these items do become more expensive the more your level increases. So right now they are still relatively cheap. Let me see. 5,000. Yeah, this is definitely more cost effective now than going to a healer. So we will stock up on them. You know what, just... Oops. Just give me as many as we can carry. Just barely not enough. You know what? Maybe we can sell some balances and some other stuff. Balances are pretty useless anyway. How much did I need? Yes, I think so. Yep, okay. So we are pretty much broke now, but we have a nice stack of red potions. Let me just check how many we have. Yeah, 45 of them, so that should last us a while. Time, I think, to upgrade our level. Now I know we're getting at least 2 or 3 wizard levels, and I'm guessing 1 or 2 fighter levels as well, so let's see how far we can get. First we will become a swordsman. So yeah, only 1 fighter level, but 1 wizard level, 2 wizard levels, 3, 4 even. Okay, 4, yeah. So 4 new wizard levels and 1 new fighter level, that gives us a total of 10 coins to upgrade with. Let's see, what do we need most of all? Like I said, I'm not going to worry about our main stats. I think we're doing more than enough damage for the moment. Wisdom. You know what, since we got this many, I think I'll put 2 points in wisdom as well. Since we're going to be relying on red potions from here on, wisdom is going to be more useful. Dexterity, I think we have enough of that. Agility. I think I want to keep 2 for magic resistance. And yeah, let's put 5 in agility. Put it up to 75. Magic resistance up to 75. Yeah, that leaves us 1 left. Let's put 1 more in wisdom as well. And then 2 more in magic resistance. That will give us a very nice spread, I think. It's pretty even all across the board now. Yeah, I think that'll do. So, since we were going to depend on... Oh well. The potions anyway. I was going to show you how much a potion heals now, but you can't use items in the town area. So we'd have to get back into the castle first. Or in the dungeon first, sorry. In fact, this is going to be a long walk all the way back to where we were. And I think we're coming up on our time limit, so I'm going to cut off the video here. I'll walk back to level 6 and go back into level 7. And yeah, meet you back there. So thanks for watching, guys, and see you in the next part.